13 kids, ages 10 to 13, from different parts of the U.S. and Canada, each with different stories and families with origins the world over, came together for a genetics and genealogy camp to research the question,
you can see your DNA very clearly.
Who am I? Who were my ancestors? Where did they come from? How are we different? How much do we share? And how far back can we go?
My dad's great-great-great-grandfather.
They're digging into their family trees and finding their roots.
Wondered where I came from and why am I here.
I was really excited to start it because I really wanted to learn about myself.
It sounded really cool, so I sent in my form to try to be part of the camp.
I thought that it would be a good experience for me because I love science and I want to study about DNA.
We're going to give you the tools to explore, the tools to explore other organisms, the tools to think about your near and distant ancestry. And the beautiful thing about this approach is that you are in the driver's seat. All you campers are doing the work of scientists. You are scientists this week.
And I'm hoping that I learned a lot here.
Well, welcome to Finding Your Roots.
One of the most fundamental questions we all ask ourselves is kind of who am I and who are we? You know, it's as natural a question as, you know, human beings have asked ourselves since the beginning of time.
I have to search all of this stuff up.
We're asking curious kids to ask questions about their own origin, about their own place in their family's genealogy, and their own place in human evolution. Basically, where do they fit in the universe of humanity?
The Finding Your Roots camps were the brainchild of Harvard professor and Finding Your Roots series host Henry Louis Gates Jr. and Penn State anthropology professor Nina Jablonski.
I knew it was a good idea. It's one thing to think you have a good idea, but this is a great idea. And no child will be left behind if we have them trace their family tree. Why? Because what's your favorite subject? Your favorite subject is yourself. Both genetics and genealogy are about your ancestry. They both offer you a window onto the past. One, the recent past, genealogy, because you can only pursue the paper trail as long as there is paper in a trail. And then when the paper trail disappears, we look into the distant past through genetics.
So by starting with genealogy and going back one generation at a time and then getting kids to imagine, what would it be like 16 or 64 generations back or 1,000 generations back? Then we are in the realm of their genetics and human evolution. They can see the continuity from themselves to their distant ancestors.
Some camps they call us children or campers, but here what they called us scientists.
What's the reason why I refer to you as scientists in this camp, and not campers, or kids, or students?
We get to, like, try to be scientists.
And, like, absolutely. So you get to be in the lab, and then you actually get to, not try, actually be scientists, right?
We spent a lot of time getting the kids to identify as scientists right from the beginning. When they realized that they could do it just as well as the adult scientists, they became empowered and excited.
Daniel Mann, he's my third.
In this web series, we'll show how young scientists build knowledge and research skills over the course of the camp.
Oh, that's so cool!
That's the DNA condensing.
Experiments and games teach lessons about mutation, adaptation, natural selection, classification.
No, these are bigger.
Evolution, differences, and relatedness.
You can show me why you think this part's longer.
But what do you think you are?
Campers will make predictions for what they think their ancestry will be.
All of my family traveled over from Europe at one time.
Well, I think I'm South Asian because I only have information about that since I'm adopted. That's what I think, yeah.
And they will open the results of their individual DNA tests conducted weeks before at the same time together.
I'm 100% European.
2% Korean.
From the big picture of genetics to the very personal of genealogy, campers learn to use all their resources, starting with their own family.
The first thing that all genealogists want to find is what we call a vital record.
Navigating the paper trail in a digital world online and going beyond the limitations of the internet by seeking out sources in the real world.
Hi. When she was in the home or something.
Like this is you and then?
After that, I guess in about the middle 30s.
All the while, each developing his or her own personal project to unveil on the final day when the doors open and they present their findings to their families.
Discovering a new aspect about oneself through one's ancestors is infectious. Genealogy puts you there. And all of a sudden, the abstractions of American history, the endless names and dates and timelines, all of a sudden, they have a face and a texture, and the face somehow resembles you. History becomes a mirror, and you can see yourself in it. It's hard to beat. Kids love to study themselves. We can show you how you can bring the tools of finding your roots into your after-school program, summer camp, or classroom. Check out what happens when kids study their own DNA and family history by viewing our education programs and trying our research-based curriculum materials. For more information, visit us online.
Major support for Finding Your Roots, The Seedlings, has been provided by the Benkovic Family Foundation, with additional support from WETA, Public Television for Greater Washington, the Hutchins Center for African and African American Research at Harvard, and the following. ¶¶